Welcome to the Siemens EDA podcast series on 3D IC chiplet ecosystems brought to you by the Siemens Thought Leadership Team. I'm your host, John McMillan. In our second podcast on 3D IC chiplet ecosystems, we talked about the models that chiplet vendors need to provide to system-in-package, SIP, integrators to facilitate a chiplet-based design ecosystem. Today, we will discuss the current state of 2.5 and 3D SIP design flows and the evolution required to support the design community to develop these 3D IC-based devices. I'm pleased once again to introduce my special guest, Tony Mastroni, who is the Director of Advanced Packaging Solutions at Siemens Digital EDA. Welcome back, Tony. Thank you for taking the time to talk with me today about 3D IC workflows. And before we dive into the discussion, would you mind giving our listeners just a brief description of your current role and background?
Yes, John, thanks for the introduction. Again, my name is Tony Mastroni, and I am responsible for developing the 2.5 and 3D IC strategies and workflows at Siemens EDA. My background prior to Siemens is primarily in the area of IC design and project management. I was involved in developing advanced packaging flows at my previous employer, which was a fabless semiconductor. I've been with Siemens for a little over a year now.
Great, thanks. So Tony, what is it about 3D IC that requires different workflows compared to traditional semiconductor packaging?
Traditional homogeneous designs include a single die or chip mounted and interconnected on a substrate inside a package, whereas heterogeneous designs include multiple chiplets inside a package. A multi-chip module, or MCM, is a packaging technology that can mount and interconnect several chips, not chiplets, on a common substrate. This technology, which has been around for many, many years, differs from the modern 2.5 or 3D technologies in that the chips mounted within an MCM are designed to be standalone ASIC devices and do not offer the full benefits of heterogeneous integration. A chiplet is specifically designed and optimized for integration into a single package in conjunction with other devices. As such, MCM devices is not what we refer to as heterogeneous integration. So the ASIC design and package design flows for traditional designs use very different design tools and models and workflows. And historically, there has not been a need to have a lot of tight collaboration between the package design teams and the ASIC design teams. So it's been largely an over-the-wall type of design process. Integrating multiple chiplets into a single system and package design requires workflows that incorporate tight integration of the package, ASIC, and even system design tools, models, and workflows. Additionally, tight collaboration between the respective RTL, ASIC, and package design teams is required throughout the planning, implementation, and verification design phases.
So what specifically is driving the need for the integration of these systems, ASIC and package design flows?
So for the past 40 years or so, Moore's Law has enabled the integration of larger portions of a system to be integrated into a single chip, referred to as an SoC or system on chip. Heterogeneous integration is enabling the decomposition of systems and subsystems into chiplet-based system and package or SIP designs. As such, system designers need to be involved early in the design process to make the necessary trade-offs in partitioning the design into the different chips and chiplets. They will need to collaborate with the RTL design architects and package design teams to assess the trade-offs early in the design process. RTL architects design and functionally verify their designs using a hardware description language, namely System Verilog. This will require the package design and planning tools to natively support Verilog, which is a major change to the traditional package design process. Having workflows that can provide early predictive analysis of system and packages is imperative, as once the system and package and ASIC design implementation begins, it's very difficult and expensive to go back and make major microarchitectural changes. Chiplet-based SoC designs will leverage standard and/or custom design chiplets but most designs will require at least one custom ASIC or possibly an FPGA to implement the specific product functionality in conjunction with the general purpose chiplet devices. This custom ASIC or FPGA design will need to interface to the other chiplets, and these interfaces will deploy the appropriate die-to-die interfaces. The I/O planning of the ASIC design requires tight collaboration with the package design lead, who's responsible for floor planning the system and package design and implementing the detailed die-to-die interconnect, as well as the interposer and package-level interconnect. Furthermore, since we are melding the package and SoC design processes, it's also necessary to have a combined set of package and SoC design verification, analysis, and sign-off and test flows.
While this sounds like a revolutionary change required for the EDA tools, workflows, and product design teams, what are the workflows you envision for 3DIC?
Yeah, John, it is indeed a revolutionary change. The good news is that for 2.5D and even stacked die type 3D designs, most of the tools exist today. Primary changes required are the development of the interfaces between these tools and scripted workflows, as well as the support for the proposed models or chiplet design kits that were proposed by the from the CDX working group. True 3D is a different story, and true 3D is where you're actually designing two custom chips and stacking those on top of each other. So today, those chips, the general packaging manufacturing technology exists today for these types of true 3D stacking, but the tools are really a work in progress. So it does require essentially 3D place and route algorithms. Those tools are actively in development, but they're not really commercially available at this point for production type designs. So these designs are currently being implemented by very few advanced companies. Again, they need very extensive IC design experience. So they're currently more of an R&D type of environment, but it is coming down the road. So the broad adoption of true 3D will likely be several years away. So these workflows that we're talking about include RTL design support, system and package level planning, analysis, physical implementation, verification, and test.
Okay, you said most of these new workflows can be built with existing tools. What new tools are required, and do any of the tools require incremental functionality?
Clearly, 3D design or true 3D design as the stacked die will require significant new floor planning and place and route algorithms. The adoption of RTL-based design flows for the 2.5D and stacked die type of applications will require package planning tools to support Verilog. So this is kind of a new introduction, Verilog support in the packaging world, in order to capture and validate the correct design intent. So timing analysis and validation will require the traditional packaging or board level type of signal integrity analysis for the high speed die-to-die interfaces. Additionally, though, for the lower speed interfaces, static timing analysis, which is a technology that's used in the ASIC world, will be required for these lower speed die-to-die interfaces. So this will require enhancements to the tools that extract the parasitics of these die-to-die interconnects and create the necessary netlist to support either the signal integrity or static timing analysis to include the effects with inside the package between the chiplets, the chips, the interposers, and the substrates. Thermal analysis is another area, and this was historically done by the package design or outsourced to OSATs commonly. So this was adequate for traditional homogeneous type of ASIC designs, but having multiple chiplets, each generating different thermal and power profiles, will require significantly more design-specific analysis, and it'll be an integral part of the design process. So although these tools exist, we will require more advanced tools to actually work down at the transistor level, as well as the analysis being introduced as part of the design process to look at the interaction, the thermal interaction between the different components in the package. So that is a change from what has been done historically for homogeneous designs. Now, since silicon interposers and organic substrates have different thermal coefficients, the thermal expansion and contraction during the manufacturing process, as well as thermal cycling while in operation, can create mechanical defects and or reliability concerns with the interconnect between the substrate and the interposer. So this is driving the need for thermomechanical stress analysis tools for 2.5D designs, as well as 3D designs for stacked die. So the die-to-die interconnect for stacked die applications would also require this thermomechanical stress analysis. And lastly, the integration of multiple chips into a single package does require the adoption of advanced design for test, or DFT, tools and methodologies, as well as tighter collaboration with the package design team and the test and DFT teams.
Which of these 3D IC workflows is or are the most critical and why?
So validation of the design intent would include logical equivalency checking, as well as LVS, layout versus schematic. And it's imperative that the system and package functionality and connectivity defined and verified by the system RTL design teams is actually captured and validated throughout the planning and design implementation process. So this is really new. These are existing tools that come from the ASIC world, but they now are going to be required to be adapted to work in the packaging world. Another important consideration is your power design network within the package, as well as the power integrity analysis. So by having multiple chips and chiplets inside the package, it does require accurate power analysis to make the necessary design of that power network and validate that each of the components is being receiving the adequate power and meeting the specification requirements for each of those chiplet components within the package. So thermal and mechanical stress analysis, 3D IC applications have much more complex thermal and mechanical reliability needs over the homogeneous type of designs. And again, we talked about testing multiple devices in the package. So this is going to require functional as well as high-speed testing of the die-to-die interfaces. So this is something that's really not applicable for a homogeneous design. But there's also a need to actually perform the detailed manufacturing tests for each of the chiplets as well within the package. Now, this will require the advanced DFT tools and tighter collaboration, again, between the DFT and test teams and the package design teams to be able to support the testing of these components once the package is assembled. And perhaps one of the most challenging needs will be to deploy security agents and trustability for each of these chiplets, as well as the integration in the design process of the system. So ASIC and at the ASIC and package level. So this is a new requirement, which is still very early in its development process, but it is likely going to be a requirement certainly for mil-aero type of applications, as well as commercial applications.
Great, Tony. Thank you again for yet another highly informative discussion on chiplet ecosystems in this third episode of our 3D IC series. We're all out of time for now, but we are looking forward to future podcasts with you on the evolution of the 3D IC workflows. And we want to thank all of our listeners for joining us today.